Hello student, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to start our new chapter. The chapter name is Water is Precious. In our life, there are many things we think that it's precious. For example, our family, our health, our friends, money, etc. But do you ever think that water is precious for us? Yes. Water is so precious for us, not only for us, but all the living things on the earth. But still, we never give more importance to water. Okay. So, in this story, we are going to see how water is important for us. And through this story, we are going to learn the importance of water. Okay. See here. You can see here one scene in this picture. You can observe that students are traveling through a bus. Okay. And two students are fighting among themselves. Now, what is the reason? Okay. So, let's see. Ravi and Mohan gotten into fight in the school bus on their way back home. This was nothing new. All the students on the bus from school to national park knew that the two would bicker the whole journey. Funny enough, Ravi and Mohan lived in same building. Little did the other students know that they often bicked right from the school gate through the whole bus journey and even on the way to their home in the lift. Okay, so see student, what did this paragraph tell to us? In this paragraph, we come to know that there is two boys, one is the Ravi and another is Mohan, and they used to fighting. Okay, and whole school also knew about it, that they are fighting. And their fighting is started from the school gate itself, through whole bus journey and even on the way to their home in the lift. Okay. Today the squabble was over the window seat. It was a hot summer day, just a week after the school had reopened since the summer vacation. The window seat on the bus was a prized possession. The fight as always continued even after they got off the bus. See, now we come to know that today's fighting. Now in this, what the scene is shown in this picture, this is what about the fight for the window seat. Okay, now this is the seating fellow is known as Ravi, and this is Mohan. Mohan is telling, and Mohan and Ravi, they are fighting on the window seat. Okay, why it is? Because this is the summer day after reopening the school. All this the window seat, it's the possession of window seat, it's about the price for all the students. And today this window seat is grabbed by the Ravi, and Mohan is telling him to, you know, give that window seat to him, and on that matter now they both are fighting. Okay, so now you would have let me sit for last at least half the trip, Ravi, Mohan exclaimed angrily. Actually, this Mohan is standing fellow is a Mohan, and he is telling that at least for half the journey you have to let me sit there, because half journey you sit and half journey I'll sit. Okay, now see what Ravi replied him. Why, Mohan, you sat near the window on the whole ride on the way to school, Ravi retaliated means angrily give back reply. Okay, so now Ravi says, why, Mohan, why should I let you sit here? Because the whole journey on the way to school you were sitting near the window. Now it's my turn. Okay, likewise he replied. Now and so it went on, and their fighting went on like this. The two were tired, hot and bothered, exhausted and dehydrated after a long summer day at school. They stepped into the lift and punched the button angrily. The door shut behind them, but they didn't move. Ravi tried pressing the button again, but the lift did not move. In desperation, Mohan jabbed at the button that opened the door, but the door shows no sign of budging. Okay, so here after long school day, it was very hot and very bothered also, and they were very exhausted. Okay, and they just stepped down from the bus and they entered their building's lift, and angrily they pushed the button. Okay, behind them the door closed, but the lift was not moving. Okay, so desperately Mohan pressed the other button to open the door, but still the door was also not opening and the lift was also not moving. Okay, so now, "Oh no, Mohan, I think the lift is stuck. What should we do?" Ravi asked as he started to panic. "Why are you freaking out? You are making me worried needlessly." Okay, so now Ravi got panic. Okay, Ravi come to know that that lift is not moving. So he said, "Mohan, I think lift is stuck." Okay, and he got panic. Mohan says that, "Why you are getting panic now? Because you were fighting with me, no? Now why you are getting panic?" Okay, so like this, Mohan replied to Ravi. Okay, "Come on, Mohan, let's not fight even now. Let's try to figure how to get out of here." The two stood in silence in the lift for a while. The Mohan piped up, "We can use this emergency phone and call the lobby. Someone will surely help us soon enough." Okay, so now, after understanding the seriousness of the matter, they both become silent and they're just trying to sort it out, this matter. They just try to figure this matter. And suddenly Mohan says that we can use this telephone, which is usually kept in lift, so we can use this telephone and we can call someone to help us. Like that, Mohan says. Okay, so on this, what Ravi says, just see. Ravi agreed, even though he hated to admit Mohan was right. The two boys called the reception. The security guard on the phone told them that they were trying to fix the problem and the boys should wait patiently. The lift could take anything from a few minutes to a few hours to be fixed. Okay, so now actually Ravi don't want to admit that Mohan suggested a very good idea, but still he admitted that yes, it's a good idea. When they called to reception pick up the phone and he told that we are trying to fixing the problem and you just have to keep patience because it can take any time. It might be some minutes or few hours. Okay, it's like this, that security guard replied to them. Okay, now the boys collapsed onto the floor. Okay, they were already tired from school and getting hungry, not to mention they were extremely thirsty. The lift was stuffy and hot, and both boys were desperate for a long drink of cold water. Ravi took out his school water bottle. He only had a few sips of water left. Mohan's water bottle was completely empty, not even a single sip left. Okay, actually there is no need to tell now that they were so hungry and thirsty because it was a summer day and they were in the school whole day. So now they want a good cold drink, and that's why Ravi took out his water bottle from his bag and there was only few sips remain. And when Mohan took out his bottle and it was totally empty. Okay, there was not a single sip of water. Then Ravi realized that Mohan had no water left to drink, even though he was always arguing with him and the two didn't get along. Ravi realized the importance of few sips of water. After taking a gulp of water, Ravi passed his own bottle to Mohan. Okay, see, actually they both were always fighting. They never be along. But today the situation was different, okay? And Ravi understood the situation. He understood the importance of water. So he just took some sip of water and he passed the bottle to the Mohan. Okay, here you go Mohan, finish whatever water is left. Your throat must be pushed, Ravi said. Okay, after having some sip of water, he just passed the bottle to the Mohan and said that now you have this water. Okay, your throat might be dry and you need of water. Okay, thank you so much, Ravi. I am extremely grateful. I will remember this gesture for a long time. Mohan truly appreciated the fact that Ravi had put aside their differences to help him in time of need. Okay, actually after offering water to Mohan, Mohan get very impressed and very grateful to Ravi because Ravi kept aside all his differences and offer him water. Okay, offer him water in his needy time. So he said that Ravi, I will never forget your gesture and I will always remember this. Okay. Some after the lift door were pried open, Ravi and Mohan walked out of the lift friendly, bonded by a new drop of water. Okay, after some time, the lift get repaired and the door get opened and both come out. But this time they were a little different. They were not enemy. They were not a fighting boys. But they were the good friend. Okay, and that friendship is bonded by a drop of water. Okay, so likewise they came out and a sip of water make them a good friend. Okay, so here we have learned that water is one of our most precious resource. We use it so much in our everyday lives. We need to be conscious about saving water. See, through this lesson, what we come to know that water is really very precious. We actually, unfortunately, we give the importance to other things but not to water. But when we are really in need, the other things doesn't come to help us, but only water come to help us. And we realize this thing by this story. Okay, so here we have to consciously use water and we should not waste it. Okay guys, so you understand the chapter, how those two students who were always fighting among themselves, they become a friend just because of they become a friend by the bond of water drop, isn't it? So now here is one thing you have to know. You can see here, did you know portion? In this did you know portion, actually some information we are going to see. See here, Cape Town. Do you know where is the Cape Town? Cape Town is the extreme end city of South Africa. Okay, so now Cape Town in South Africa was the world's first major city to go through severe water crisis. Capetonians were only allowed to use up to 50 liters of water per day. They should wash their cars and water their garden less. Everyone was encouraged to have a short bath. Day zero or the day they completely ran out of clean water was expected to be 2018, but has been delayed to 2019 because of the efforts on the part of the citizens to save water. As we are greater than expected rainfall, Bangalore is the most likely city in India to run out of water. Take a look at this picture of the citizens of Cape Town in South Africa. How do you think they feel? See, in this chapter, as we are going to see the importance of the water. So in the world, Cape Town is the first city who faced the crisis of water. Okay, and it was the deadline in and the deadline was given to Cape Town that in 2018 it will be totally run out by the water. Okay, But because they took efforts, now it delayed to 2019 and now we are in 2000. So I don't know that what is the condition of Cape Town, but student, the such condition should not come to us, though we have abundant amount of rainfall, but still we have to use water very precisely, because water is very precious, and this resource, if we run out by this resource, we can't live. Okay, so here you can see this picture, how the people in Cape Town, they face the problem. They just have to allow 50 liter of water per day, and they were taking a short bath, and they were not allowed to wash their cars, and they less gardening and all. So this is what all about the lesson. Okay, I hope you understand.